Absolutely. When's the last time you've been in Arizona?
I don't know, man. It's been a minute. I mean, I was there on my like last tour and shit, but that was like a year ago almost. So
right,
it's
right.
It's about to be crazy.
Okay, so tell the people what you got going on, because I know you're always busy. You got projects left and right. What's going on with the label? What's going on with the music?
Right now.
What's that?
Man, I'm in the studio right now. I'm working on Black Sheep 4, man.
That's Black Sheep 4. Okay, that's what's
all
up.
All my focus is on that right now. Yeah, I'm pretty much in here every day.
Let me ask you a question, man. I know that the Black Sheep has kind of been your thing. A lot of people have their different idea of what that really means. But what does it mean to you? Why did you come up with Black Sheep?
I mean, when I came up with Black Sheep, it was more about just how I felt in culture. It wasn't really about being the Black Sheep of my family or nothing like that. It's just more or less like I just always felt like completely different from just the culture and world that was around me. And then as I got into music, it's just crazy that Black Sheep just followed me and stayed with me, and like it literally applied to me in the music industry too. Like I just feel like that about me in so many different aspects of my life, you know. But yeah, it's just about being proud of being yourself and being different.
Yeah, absolutely. You do it well. So how long have you really been, would you say, like in the industry? Because I know it takes a lot to, you know, break in. And then once you're in, you know what I'm saying, then it kind of starts all over again. But what would you say, how long has it been for you?
Well, see, I started with Baby in like, I want to say 2012, so like 5 years. But like when I first, see, that was my entrance into the industry. But I was really like a brand new artist at that time. I didn't get signed to Cash Money because I had like a single or like I was a popping artist. I literally just met Bird and we kicked it off and just had a dope relationship. And, you know, that was like my entry into the industry. But, you know, I just moved out to LA in December. So I feel like now I'm really entering the industry, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. So a lot of people may be wondering, like, how did you meet Birdman and how did this whole thing happen? Because I mean, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's super crazy, man. I mean, I had a homie in Florida that I was making music with. I had did a couple songs with him, and basically just through one event or another, some of his music was getting played in the studio that Bird was in, and then this record came on that I was on. It was a music video, and Bird was like, yo, who's this white kid, blah blah blah. And then like a week later I got a phone call. She's like, yo, Stunna. And I was like, I didn't believe it. I was like, yeah. But so like he called my phone, and I stay in Orlando, so I was like 3 hours away. I drove to Miami, kicked it with him, and just like I played him all my music like just one night. I just played him everything I got, and he was just like, man, like let's rock out. It was like we didn't really talk much more about like, do you want to sign, nothing like that. Like we just both knew, yeah, like, yeah, let's rock.
I mean,
it's dope and organic, you know. Most people's label situations aren't like that, you know?
Right? Not with the Hefe. Yo, so I mean, when you get a cosign like that from someone like Birdman, who's a legend, you know what I'm saying, within hip hop and one of the biggest music moguls in the game, that kind of does something to your confidence, right?
Yeah, definitely. Good things and bad things, for sure.
Yeah.
it's good in the sense that it's like, yo, it's a reminder of like, yo, I really do got this. It's like a, you know, reiterating that, yo, you really got this talent. But then I think also at the time when it happened, it was like I hadn't even really understand fully at the time, like just how much work I needed to put in, because I worked a lot at that time as an artist. But yeah, you know, it's just mad different. So at that time, I think that like I maybe, you know, miss a boat on like how much work I should be putting in. And that's something I've had to learn through just being in the game, you know. Like just, this is the rap game, not easy, you know. Any rapper, you know, it's not easy. So
right,
but all those are good lessons, you know.
So I have a question.
Yeah,
talking to the phone.
Yeah,
what advice do you have for artists who are on the come up, or you know, the dream chasers out there? I want to know what you would tell them.
Well, see, it's funny, at different points in my life I probably have a different answer to this. Right now, my number one thing would just be like, dedicate every day to it. Like, if you really want to make a life out of me, I mean, it's with anything, you know. If you want to be a painter, you want to be a writer, you want to be anything, you got to put in work towards it every single day and just devote all your hours towards it. It can't be like a hobby and you hope it turns into your career. It really can't be like that, you know?
Right. So give it everything. Okay.
Yeah, because there's no really, you know, the internet has given so many opportunities. So there's no like shortcut way of like, you know, do this and that and you'll be a rap star. It's like everybody's figuring it out and it's always changing, you know? So it's just important to like get your hands dirty, because that's when you really find out the gems and what works for you.
Right.
I feel like okay, so here at Icon Radio, like we're the home of quality independent music. So we play a lot of everything we play, we focus on is independent. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of artists that they're, you know, they are grinding every day, you know, they work hard and, you know, they're trying different things. And then one day your life will change. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, how was it for you when you went from like the independent game and just kind of grinding on your own to one day all of a sudden you would cash money?
Yeah, it's crazy. It's like you put in all these hours and then you don't know how the reward's going to come back, you know? So it's like, you know, you just put in all the work and you keep working and making music and all this shit and you don't expect the outcome. You just focus on the process, and then it's just like one day, you know, people think it happens overnight. They think like, oh, just Bird called you one day. It's like really it's the accumulative years and hours of work that equal that, you know? Mm-hmm.
What's the one thing that you can attest to, the, like, what was something that you did, you're like, okay, this is what got me here? Like, what was it? I mean, you know, I know you work hard, but ultimately, what was it for Caskey? Because I feel like you got something very unique, and that's whatever that was is obviously what Bird saw. What do you think it was?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I wonder that a lot. I think a lot of it's just authenticity, you know? I think that shines through to people. And they just, you know, like, I don't know, just something about honest work, you know, like honest music, honest, just being yourself, that really, I think that's worth more than really anything you could do as an artist.
Okay, that's what's up. All right, so you got hella projects out there, and you got a low key cult fan base, bro. Like, I've been to a couple of your shows, and like some of these cats, like, they really are out here for you.
I love it.
what's next for them? Like, what do you have? You got something in store for them? Or what you got?
Yeah, I'm really just about to go crazy. Like, I moved out to LA, you know, just so I could be surrounded by other people that's working, you know. And then like through being out here, I'm just submerging myself in the work, so that when we come out with BS4 it's something crazy. I'm trying to get Birdman to move out to LA because he's coming out here soon. But pretty much me and Legit Looks is about to go super crazy. I'm trying to unleash music. Like, once I drop Black Sheep 4, I'm gonna just try to stay on like a video a week for the rest of the year vibe. Yeah. Because I know we could do that, you know.
Yeah, consistency is the key nowadays. Yo, do you ever like wake up and be like, yo, I'm signed to a label that's associated with some of the biggest artists of all time?
Birdman, Drake, Nicki Minaj, that's crazy.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's crazy. That's wild.
Still doesn't feel real, you know.
Yeah. All right, so for this next project, you got any features, anything lined up? You can
not that I'm gonna confirm right now. Yeah. I don't wanna promise nothing before it happens.
Right, right. Okay. And then is this the Black Sheep 4 tour, or are you just you stopping in Phoenix?
This Phoenix show isn't part of that. This is just the pre S4.
Ah.
But I'm gonna drop the tape in probably around a month, and then we're going Black Sheep 4 nationwide tour, gang.
Okay, that's big. All right, and where can people follow you? Are you big on social media?
Yeah, everything at Caskey 407, Caskey 407, everything. I talk to everybody on all my socials.
Okay. Yo, man, we look forward to seeing you, meeting you. Hopefully, if you in town early, man, hopefully we can get you by the station, you know what I'm saying? But
yeah, definitely, I'm there.
If not, we'll see you at the venue, all right?
All right, it's Love Friday. We there, Black Sheep Gang.
All right, appreciate you. Caskey, one time.
Love y'all. Be safe.
Peace. All right.